Hey YouTube, I'm playing Borderlands. Nobody's asked, but I decided I would. Here we are. Okay, so it doesn't take too long, the loading thing. However, the beginning cutscene can be pretty boring. So I'm going to be quiet as it happens. So I just got home from school. It's 5:53.
You want to hear a story, huh? One about treasure hunters. Have I got a story for you, Pandora? This is our home, but make no mistake, this is not a planet of peace and love. They say it's a wasteland, that it's dangerous, that only a fool would search for something of value here. Then perhaps I am a fool, but do not be fooled by what Pandora appears to be. There was a legend, many people tell it, the legend of the vault. My father would always go on about the vault, even with his dying breath. Advanced alien technology, infinite wealth, fame, power, women. So you can understand why some little kiddos who hear the stories grow up to become vault hunters. Well, I have a story you may not believe, but I tell you it is true. The legend of the vault is real. And it is here on Pandora. And let's call her a guardian angel, appeared to guide the vault hunters to their prize. The tale begins right here on Pandora with the brave vault hunters, the guardian angel, and most importantly, me.
Cool. I love this part. I think there's a skag.
Time to wake up. It's a beautiful day, full of opportunity. No rest for the wicked until we close our eyes for good. 15 minutes later, I'm still walking down the street when I saw the shadow of a man creep out of sight.
Mordecai the Hunter. As the Hunter. Lilith as is something, as like the Adept. I wanted to call her an Adept because I was playing Mass Effect the other day. Siren, okay. Him as the soldier, I don't even know his name. Roland as the soldier. And Brick as himself. See?
Stone Depot. Time to gather up your stuff. Who's getting off the bus? You with the sniper rifle and the crazy mask. You look like a Traxican wrestler moonlighting as a dominatrix, man. And you, soldier man. Are those armor pieces from the Crimson Lance you're wearing? And what's your story, young lady? What can you do? Perhaps you can bake us all a wonderful cake. And you, beefsteak in the back. I'm not gonna make fun of you. Your burps smell of blood, and you growl like a rabid animal. Anyway, I've got some advice for all of you. It's tough out there, and you won't be able to just feed up on whatever you please until you're ready. Sure, you can take from the bandits or find things in the wild, but equipment you buy from my stores are guaranteed. And if you die, you can't get your money back because you're dead. I kid. No need to be so serious here. And if you're looking for the vault, going to have your work cut out for you. So don't be afraid to spend what it takes to get the equipment you need. You listen to Marcos. I come from 7 generations of merchants, and I'm the best. Want to know why? Because I'm making it out here, in this place.
Okay, I think that's it. So, I think we'll pick the hunter, Mordecai. He's my favorite.
Don't be alarmed. I need you to stay calm and don't let on that anyone is talking to you. Start making your way off the bus. You don't have any reason to trust me, but I need you to believe that I'm here to guide you. I'm here to help you find the vault. In a moment, you'll be greeted by a funny little robot. Do everything he says. You'll know what I mean when it happens. I'll contact you again soon.
Well, we're here. Don't worry about saying goodbye. I'm sure we'll be doing this all again soon enough. Get off my bus.
Okay. That works. Let's just wait for another loading screen. Okay, loading screen's almost done. Long loading screen. Okay.
See you next time.
Okay, bye Claptrap. Okay, we're out. We can't move yet.
Welcome to Firestone. I am CL4PTP. You may call me by my locally designated name, Claptrap. Before continuing, please accept this echo communication device and heads-up display, provided free of charge by the Doll Corporation.
Okay, can we go now? Let's get ready to rumble. Oh no.
Great! I detect that your echo device is fully functioning. This way, please.
Okay. So we work now. Now, something I want to point out is that you don't have to use the. You only have to use your mouse to look vertically because I'm using the arrow keys. It's used this for vehicles, but also use my mouse. Got that. And then right here, about to see some bandits fly over, but. First, let's upgrade ourselves.
Okay.
Okay, Claptrap. I've already heard this.
Please activate the new use station now.
Okay, I'm gonna go through you. See, how does it feel? Probably not very good. Okay, so our guy's Mordecai, but I don't like that, so let's call ourselves Captain Picard. Ooh, okay, so how should we customize? I guess we'll go... I like this color. Okay. Because we're not ever going to see ourselves, so I like his red goggles, so we'll keep that red. Let's change change that to a darker shade of blue. Okay.
Excellent! Now that your DNA is registered, you have the best in horrific death and dismemberment insurance. Should an unfortunate fatal incident occur, your new you will appear at the nearest station. Now we can head into the peaceful town of Firestone. Please, follow me.
Okay, Clappy. We're about to see some bandits, and we're just going to have to snipe them down.
Again.
I never understood how they go up there. He does so much fun in there. Okay. Can't play. I really love the art style of this game.
Are they gone? Whew. Those bandits really have it in for us claptraps. Using us as target practice is not part of our programming. And open!
Okay, so I'm about to snipe him. I don't really like how the detection on this thing works. It's not hard to kill them though. If you're like me and you actually like to use precision rather than going in guns blazing. But I mean, for some certain boss fights I will do that. Like Nine Toes, the first boss. It's fun really getting under his skin. Ooh, okay, I just realized there's money here. This fan is beer. Okay. He's curled up in a little ball, and his head is gone. Now, before people ask, the guy on the front cover of Borderlands is called the Psycho. Now, I think this will go on the official Venusaur channel, maybe, probably not, because, I decided, if you haven't seen my video about the many flaws of RP role-playing games, I said I would be starting a new series, which I had already recorded. I was starting a Let's Play of Enclave, and it's kind of like your standard RPG. It would probably be as... Uh-oh. Okay, that's good that there's health right there. Some butt. Okay, oh crap. Okay.
You scared? You should be.
Bandit raiders are a little harder to kill if you're just using your regular gun. And I do know for a fact there are guns up here. Okay. And it is a pistol. It's two actually.
The box is awaiting your attention.
That's what I got last. Yep.
Wow! Looks like it could do some damage.
Okay, so let's see. We got a bunch of repeater slugs. Okay, so that's 10 damage, 12 damage. Okay, so I'll just take, okay, well, I guess we will use this red gun. And we'll probably sell the... Oh, sorry, Claptrap. We'll probably sell the other gun. However, you can actually press tab. That's the default opening your inventory button. You can switch now for the RF repeater, which I like the way it scopes more. Like that one, it scopes like that. And BLR swatter, it scopes like that. And because of the fact I already have a precision weapon, I don't really need it. So I think we'll use this for now. Also, it provides more damage, which I like.
Quick, this way.
And it's probably not, I don't think it will make it let you sprint any more faster. I'm not sure how weapons are differently classified. But I do know, it definitely makes me feel like I'm going faster. shoot. So that guy's pretty far away. So we can just take him down. Yeah. And then we'll shoot him once. Now we may die right now. So let's try and shoot him. Okay, let's dash to get this. Okay, I think we got... Okay, we didn't get shot right there. Okay, that's a bad idea. So let's just run up with a knife. Take some of this. I like getting cash, a lot of cash. I mean, you can call me a hoarder in this game, because I'm taking everything I possibly can, although your opinion will quickly change, since I don't keep any guns, or I only keep the guns that are absolutely essential. I sell or drop the other ones. Like, if I'm in the middle of a mission, like in the middle of a boss mission, I found a really awesome gun, then I'll probably just, and my inventory's almost full. Then either I will keep my current gun that I'm going to replace.
Get those some bitches.
Oh, that's nice. Or okay, that's nice.
Another day.
So let's try. And okay, we just leveled up. That's good because when you get okay, I guess that guy gave us slugs. Just forgot about it. Shoot him in the head. Now, your starting weapons will change depending on the class you use. I know that if you use the Berserker, which is brick, then you will get a scattergun and a shotgun. They are shotguns, but they call them scatterguns in here because who knows why.
Excellent.
Also, all your health and shields regain. Shields, if you don't know about, we'll learn about later. But when you level up, your health and shields, as I said, will regain. Okay, now let's use this. Okay, exit.
I'm over here.
Okay.
Attention, citizen of Firestone.
This doctor's
in. There is no cause for alarm. This new visitor has resolved the problem.
Well, shoot! I thought I was a goner that time. Damn bandits won't leave us alone. Had to lock the place up tight. I'll let you in. Come on. Damn it. Blasted circuits are on the fritz again. Give it a go from the switch out there, would you?
Okay. So we get XP just by doing really simple things. Building 3. Open this building 3. You just go look at the green thing and click E.
Depending on what mission is currently active in your mission.
Claptrap, be quiet, please. Okay, thank you. Okay, here's Dr. Zed. I like taking a screenshot every time like one of these happens, like right here. You'll see one. And like this picture happens, like right here. Zed. Kind of like TK Baja.
Thanks for opening her up again.
Maybe collect XP for that.
Cut on folks anymore since I lost.
Okay, now let's go kill some skags.
Now that we're done with all that, please follow me and I'll open the gate for you.
Now, I'm not in any sense going to call this a speed run because it is. Oh, these are grades, I'm pretty sure, which is kind of stupid. Or, it's not stupid, sorry, kind of sad. And immediately, I'm pretty sure that's a pup skag. No, never mind. We have to talk to TK Baja after this. He's like a guy who always talks about you should have seen the look on your face. He says that's one of his first lines he said, even though he's blind. Oh, hey, bandits. This like reminds me of that thing from SpongeBob where he like sees something extreme happening and he looks at his coffee and he sighs. He's like, I gotta lay off the coffee. Oh, crap. Okay, that was easy. And I miss. Shoot him in the shoulder. Shoulder blades are easy to take out. Oh, okay. Now this lady's gonna talk to us. Excuse me. I'm trying to complain here. Excuse me. Okay.
Looks like he got under Nine Toes' skin.
Okay, Nine Toes is the boss. He's hilarious.
You did it. I knew you were the right choice. Oh,
let's go get the repair kit.
The robot needs our help. Would you kindly give him a hand?
There's the repair kit right there. This little table. Also, see, there's like a little, if you go over the map right here, there's a little diamond. That's where your objective should be. So if you didn't understand where that was for some reason, which can happen if somebody doesn't explain it good enough, it's kind of right there under that red flag.
Why don't you look around for something to fix him up?
I just did. Okay, Claptrap, now open the gate.
Good as new, I think. Am I leaking?
He seems to be okay.
Claptrap, you have
now
quite the personality.
Get moving and play your part.
You can jump pretty high in this game, I know. I gotta make a game theory episode about that. I hope they make NatPat 13 will make a game theory episode about how realistic Borderlands is, something like that. Cause I've only had this game for a few days, but I love it. Well, not love. I'm not sure if I'm ready. So let's just shoot this skag. Now, skags will play a big role in the story as being the most annoying enemy early on. It is a slightly bigger pup skag. And then there will be like an upgraded form called the skag whelp, which are much more powerful than skags. But they're not nearly as powerful as some of the others, like the skag spitter, the elder skag, and the adult skag. And I'm pretty sure one of the bosses is a skag. I know that. At least that's when I was in my playthrough.
I'll see you in a few.
Okay. Oh wait, let's go. Okay. Let's see, somebody has. You know, I should message back, saying, "Not now. I'm recording." Now I'm not gonna message. I'm gonna message him after this, because I know how annoying that can be, because I saw a YouTube video where a guy kept messaging his friend in the middle of it. And I don't think you should be doing YouTube videos if you're not going to put enough time in it. Okay, he says K. Okay, let's see. So let's look around here. Now, if you didn't know, my Let's Plays now are starting to be 30 to 45 minutes long. I've been promising that. Okay. So we need to get the power cow. Power cow. We need the power cow. Wait. Okay, I'm pretty sure it's through the gate, yeah. Now, I like using the pistol. I actually like using the weapon that takes up the smallest amount of screen, especially when I'm recording. Because this has happened before. Of course, I don't. Now, you may think that these episodes aren't exactly the highest quality, but typically I will do multiple takes on Let's Plays. I know that's weird to think about, but if I don't think the content is good enough, I don't post it. People complain that I don't post Let's Plays enough. I had someone private message me on YouTube about that we need to crack Pina and I need to do more Let's Plays. Now I don't even know if he's even going to be doing Let's Plays other than his craft. At least not for a while, because we don't pull money out of our butts and YouTube gives us like $1 a month, not even. So we can't go out and buy a bunch of cool equipment. Not yet, at least. one day I'm hoping not to like have like a YouTube as a job. It'll always be a hobby for me, trust me. It'll never be a job. I'm almost never have full sniper rifle bullets, but I do often in the beginning. So you'll know that it gets much harder. Sometimes I can't even use my sniper rifle because it's almost out of ammo. And anyway, what I was saying earlier is when I'm doing Let's Plays, I like to have the weapon that takes up the smallest amount of speed. Let's see if in the options we can change training messages off. What's aim assist? I'm not gonna change it. Okay. So once that sprinting goes away, I don't think we'll ever see it again. Okay. Now we purchase a shield.
The medical equipment working.
They're all the exact same. Yep.
Is there something like
need? For the help. You ought to use the machine to sell some.
And then here you can get other stuff. See, these mines are instant heal. It'll be random for you, cause the last time I didn't get money in that, I didn't get any heal in that, I got ammo in one of these, and there is money in that one. I think it's mostly money. For the most part, it'll just be money.
I might not have a med school degree, but when you get shot, you'll be happy I'm here. That'll do for now.
People don't yet trust you. If you're going to ever find the vault,
kind of
you need the aid
really.
Of the people. Helping Dr. Zed with his nine toes problem is a good move.
Okay, let's get up here. Now all we have to do is like headshot a couple guys and we'll be leveled up to level 3. That's plainly obvious. Plainly obvious, I don't know. But I've gotten to Sledge, which Borderlands fans will definitely know who he is. Who Sledge is, because... Sorry, I was just checking the clock. Sledge is kind of one of the... Is pretty much the... Coming from my friend, Alex. Okay, there's a bandit raider right there. He's level 10. Let's take him out. Fire. Get ready. And I missed. See the skull right there next to his head that's glowing? Means don't take him on. Seriously. You're screwed if you do. Uh-oh, is that a grenade? Holy crap, that's a grenade. And... Okay, let's take out this guy. And there's a burning psycho. There's a midget here. They're really easy to take down, but let's not aggravate them. Let's get out of here. Those 6 sniper rifle rounds from earlier would have been helpful. Oh no. Uh-oh. We'll get a lot of XP for taking him out, but he is not an easy guy to take. Oh, crap.
Strip the flesh, salt the wound.
Okay, this is mean. Guys, help. Anybody? Anybody at all? Good thing we have a shield, or else we'd be dead. Okay, here's a sniper rifle round.
It's time for my pound of flesh. It's time for another pound of flesh.
Jeez, dude, what's with you? What's with you? In the flesh, like. What's a spammer pistol attack? Pistol attack, go! Am I gonna die here? Let's make this count.
Time to play. Time to play.
Play what? No, nub. Oh, and okay, he already got me down. Let's just respawn. No! I never die! Not yet! But no, okay, I'll die. Okay, let's not aggravate him. It's probably a bad idea to take him on when he's a really high level. Let's see what's in there. Oh, nice. You can jump up and grab. How do I get up there? You might need to jump on this rock and. Yeah, and we got our nice little snake. Oh, I can bring the psycho in here and he'll. Oh, now, Claptrap.
Oh, come on, get down.
No. Hey, psycho. Who you calling psycho, psycho? Okay, I think we got him to chase us. Yep. Good thing they can't jump.
It's hot.
Meow. Look at this.
Time to play.
Ow. Does he have like an unlimited? Ow, no. Go away. Probably gonna kill us. Okay, now let's just sneak out in the middle of the night. Or in the morning. Haha! Take that, bandit. Crud, no skags. The headshot and get XP. Oh, and he's chasing us. Okay, that'll be fun. What is a meat puppet? Okay, I'm pretty sure I saw a skag attacking one of these guys. I'm not 100% sure. We'll try and run into some area where some skag might be. Oh, I've got an idea. You're probably thinking this. Already, that I should get him out here and let him kill me. I think he's buzzed off. That's right, chump, run.
Come on, little one.
Oh,
time to die.
He's a bandit raider. Come on, little one, time to die. Like if somebody told me it was time to die, I would probably not really want it to be. Yep, okay, I was right. Captain Picard is now level 3. Whoever thought they'd say that again? What? Now, I know that if you like, you can be stealthy enough, then you can take out a guy. If he's the only guy in an area, then you won't get detected by enemies. And that's always an awesome feeling. But I mean, this game has like pretty much no stealth mechanic other than you sneaking around inside the enemy. Oh, okay, bye-bye for him. Other than you sneaking around in the enemy base trying not to get detected. Okay, we got it on him. Let's see. And we miss. You know, I've been realizing I have a lot of friends that, well, I mean, I don't have like a bunch of friends. I have like 4 or 5 that I like to, that I can really call my friends. But, I notice a lot of them, like, they don't, when they're on the phone, like, they don't speak English to their parents. I'm not sure if it's just where I live, but they'll be like speaking like Puerto Rican or something. I mean, I don't live in Puerto Rico or anything, but I feel like one of my friends who was speaking Russian to his mom, who didn't speak English apparently, but his dad was bilingual. He was bilingual as well. Whoa, a pistol. Okay, we got a double repeater. I wonder if there's a. Okay, where's the dub? Okay, so that's 8 times 2. Oh, okay. So we can drop, no, not the PLS swatter. Okay. Let's tab the RF repeater, we can drop it. We have this epic thing. It does 16 damage pretty much, and it's got cool accuracy.
Time to die.
See? And that's a good amount of ammo to use. Whoa. Oh, it's a Oh, that's a weapon I already got. I thought that was a revolver. Because revolvers are... have got to be extremely rare this early in the game. But your guy later in the game will be known for using revolvers. Like, in even in his summary, it says most known for using sniper rifles and revolvers. Although, you're not going to... You'd probably be a while through the story. You'll probably be level 15 before you even... Like, in your playthrough, you'll likely be level 15 before you even get to your first revolver. I say this because I was level 12 when I found my first, and the level limit was, or the minimum level was 13. So I had to headshot a few people. Save up. For some points to pick him. I'm surprised it's not lagging a bunch. Typically, it's only about, I'm getting like a good 25 FPS right now. Odd, because every time I look at my videos, it looks like it's lagging more than it does when I'm recording it. Sometimes, oh snap. Vlad off. Oh my gosh. Holy crap. Okay, well, what's this? The rolling sniper. I have to be level 5. Okay, that's good enough. I have to be level 4 for that. Okay. Well, let's go and kill some dudes. Get some levels. If you do every quest there is, then you'll be at least like level like 20 by the time you get to when I was only level. You'll probably be at least level 15 actually by the time I was level 13, because most of the quests I just skipped, only the ones that were like part of the story. Now right here, I like sliding down this. It's kind of cool how they made that so you can slide down. I'm not touching the keyboard, look. Whee! It works better on this side. Let me just jump up. Now, I like how it kind of looks like a comic book. Even though the graphics are really low resolution. See, look at that. Depending on what angle you're at. But I don't mind, because this game is older. I think it's like 2000... Oh, there's a pup skag. No. Bad dog. Bad dog. See, we get XP. I get XP for doing criticals. So will you. I think. Or killing them with a critical hit.
Feel it.
You get a certain amount of XP. And I'm not sure if it's just for the hunter, because that's the only one I've really noticed that. Like, my brother, Fancy Chicken, who I've talked about a little bit in these Let's Plays, and he's done a couple with me. And him, I bought him Borderlands as when I bought Borderlands, because I'm a nice guy. You know that? I'm a genuinely, well, at least what I can assume, I call myself nice at least, because I have a couple friends who I will remain unnamed, and they fight all the time, something. Their brothers and everything. But I think it's because they just agree on different things. Like, the younger brother, he's one of those guys, he kind of likes Roblox and all that. And he plays Steam a fair bit with me. And his older brother, who's actually a lefty like me, who's shorter than his younger brother. You probably know who this is if you know me in real life. I'm just not going to say it for the internet. But, He doesn't really play on Steam, and they can argue a lot over their opinions, which I think is definitely fair. I mean, Noah and I don't really argue. The only person I really argue is Crack Peanut when we're arguing about something stupid, like The other day we were arguing about our favorite zombie in Left 4 Dead. Of course, me being me, I said the hunter. I don't even know what he said. I think it was like a boomer or the smoker or something. And the smokers, I just realized now, as saying this, they kind of look like skags. Like, because they do the thing with their tongue. Also, okay, let's take that 18 repeater slugs. Sup. Screenshot. That's gonna be the thumbnail.
One more step and it'll be your last. You should have seen the look on your face.
Well, I mean, the reason I did short let's plays like 8 or 9 minutes was because we had to turn into TK Baha after we met him. Well, he has one leg. I just realized that. Or his leg's the chair. If you close one eye, right here, it looks like his leg is the chair. See? Isn't that funny? Because you use your eyes for depth perception.
Don't worry about me, I'll take care of myself.
Okay,
goodbye,
now let's go steal some food.
Right. Okay.
He gives you one gun a little later in the story called TK's Wave, and I loved it. Like, for the time I had it. Okay, excuse me. See, look at the tongue thing. Crack Pina, you watch this. He does the tongue thing like smokers do in Left 4 Dead. See? Of course, he doesn't pull you in and make your teammates save you. And then get kicked from a lobby for getting smokered in the beginning of the game because your friends made you get out there first to make sure the coast was clear. They weren't really my friends. They're just some people online. I don't even know them. Like, when you play an online game, like, with random people, they're not always gonna be all your friends. However, one time, I was online, and I was just, like, playing on an online match, like, random of Call of Duty, and I found my, like, there was one person in the lobby. Oh, okay, did that skag eat a gun? Because it says when they die, they, like, regurgitate whatever they ate. Cheap repeater. Albert's Mag 14, 8, 16, 77, 65, 3.6, 3.3. Okay. Well, I'm going to drop it because of the low power. The nasty repeater just looks so great. Now, as I was saying, you can try to get headshots for more XP. That wasn't giving me XP though, because apparently the game didn't think as. See, that's the gun. Looks like mine. Jeez, people. Did I just go steal your food already? Give me a hard time. That's the pee wash over there. That'll be in a later episode, I think. But, you have to get a car, and you jump over it, you drive over it. And you have to do it after defeating one enemy called Bonehead, and he's a total pain in the butt. Excuse me, can I headshot you, or are you gonna be a butt about it? Nope. Okay, I'll just knife. Because you get XP for knifing and killing. Which is odd to think about, like, do you get more? Oh, and I think I got XP because that was critical. Not sure. Okay, let's look on the map. Where's the next one? Oh, it's not too far out. Yep, it's just over here. Okay. Oh, crud. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. That is a skag whelp. Those things are hard to take down this early. Of course, they just become an inconvenience later. That can be defeated with a shot or two. But at that, I think I'm going to finish the episode. Let's just steal this food. Hi, Nathan. And try to run out here before we get killed by the skags. Well, let's knife him. Okay. Ah, poo. Okay. Yeah, let's just dodge them. Okay, they don't run too fast. And they're not very independent. They typically stay as a group. Although it's almost as they have their own free will, because always one or two of them will follow me. And they all kind of have their own fighting pattern. Like, some of them will try and do a smokers do. I'll just say licking. They try to lick. That'll probably come up a few times in the series. They'll try to lick you, and others will try and jump on you. Others will try and chase you down until your guy can't sprint no more or something, or you think you lose him, and then bam, he jumps into you, bites you. It's actually, after you get your shield, it's pretty rare to get killed by a skag of a lower that isn't like an adult or an elder or something.
You need something?
Oh, poo, wrong guy. Okay, let's turn into TK Baja. And after that, we hope the grenade store opens, so we might have to buy a restorative shield, one that will restore your health. Really slowly, but still does restores your health if it's equipped, nonetheless. Yeah, okay, it's a bandit thug. Okay, now that he's on low health, we'll try and critical him. If not, he's still. Okay, yep. See, we're almost level 4. We'll probably get at least a few. Okay, now let's, oh, I just realized, when you shoot, it's pretty much 7 bullets per mag doing 16 damage. That's pretty much what it is, but.
Hey, newcomer. I've been looking for you.
I know, you've always been looking for me. You say that every time I talk to you. Okay, so I think that is the last episode we'll do. So thanks for watching, and see you later.
I've decided to reopen my Firestone franchise thanks to you. Head into town and buy some new gear.
Thanks for watching.